Welcome to Programming Knowledge. In this tutorial, we are going to discuss about collections in Dart. There are basically three built-in collections that ships with Dart. One of them is list. List is very similar to arrays that we have in most of the other programming languages. We can define a list by writing the keyword list and then the name that we want to give to the list and a pair of square brackets. So in this manner, we have created a variable of list which has a name and it has been initialized and it has no values in it. And suppose if I want to initialize with certain values inside it, then I can simply write them inside the square brackets, and to add more than one value, we can just separate them by a comma. So over here, I have a list name which has two values stored in it, Rishabh and Ram. So list also follows the basic indexing concept that we have in most of the programming languages except Pascal, Fortran, etc. That is, the indexing starts at 0. That means this Rishabh is stored at an index 0 and Ramesh is stored at index 1. So to print the values at a certain index, we just need to write it inside the print statement and followed with a square brackets, and inside square brackets we need to write the index. And now if I click on run, Rishabh should be printed. And now if I change the index from 0 to 1, Ramesh should be printed. And over here I can also change this list to var, and it should not give us any error. This is because Dart, with the help of type inference, automatically converts this variable name to a type or to a list type which has strings value stored in it. Now we can have values of more than one data type stored in the list. So to do so, if I write 100, which is an integer, and if I also try to add a double value, then this will work and it will not give us any error. So if I click on run, 100 should be the output. Now suppose I want to loop through each of the values, then the most easiest way is to use a for each loop. So for that I'll write var I in name, and then inside this I'll just print I, and then I should be able to see all the values that I have inside the list. And now if I want, I can also change the values at a certain index in the list. So if I want to change the value at index 1 in the list name, then I can just simply change it to Suresh, and this should work. And it is not necessary to change a string value to another string value only. We can give it a integer value also. And now if I click on run, 1, 2, 3 should be displayed instead of Suresh. So it is working fine. And now suppose we want to have a list that only stores string, then what we can do is we can change this var to list, and after that inside angular brackets I'll define the data type. That means only string values should be there. So you can see the red line below this integer and float values. It is basically there because we have defined the list as a string values container list, and it cannot store integer and double. So if I remove this, then it will not be a problem. Now if I click on run, Rishabh and Ramesh should be printed. Now let me change it back to var, and I'll remove this comment, and then I want to change the value at index 1 from Ramesh to 1, 2, 3, and then if I click on run, then it is changing. Okay, and now suppose I don't want to change the value at runtime. So what I can basically do is I can put a const over here which makes the values stored inside the variable name as a constant. So now you can see over here I am declaring the variable name as a constant, and after that I am trying to change a value. So if I run this, it should give me an error. So over here you can see uncaught error, unsupported operation, indexed set. And now if I comment this again and try to run this, then this should not be an error. Now after that, suppose I want to copy this list to another variable. So for that I'll create a new variable n, and I'll just simply write name, and over here in the loop I'll change this name to n. And now if I click on run, the output will be same. Okay, but now if I change the value of name, means any value of the list name, then the values in list n will also change. Okay, so it is giving me an error because I have a const over here. So I'll just remove the const for now for the explanation purpose. So now if I click on run, it is still giving me an error. It is because I have missed a semicolon over here. So now if I give the semicolon and run this again, so over here you can see that if we change the values stored in the variable name, then the values stored in variable n is also changing. So basically over here it doesn't copy the set of values, but both the list variables point at the same location, that is the location of the data in the memory. So to avoid this, we have a special function that is prefabricated in Dart known as spread operator. JavaScript developers might be familiar with this. So over here what we basically do is we surround the variable name with square brackets, and before writing the variable name we just simply give three simple dots. And now after assigning, if we change the value of the previous list or the original list, then it will not be reflected in the new list. So now if I click on run, the output should be Rishabh and Ramesh. So this is how we get the two different copies of a list. So this was for list. See you in the next tutorial. Thank you.